Hi, my name is Johnny. If I were to tell you that one word managed to turn me into a millionaire, would you believe me? Well, let me tell you, it's the truth. The word no made me a millionaire. And if you don't believe me, keep watching to figure out how it all happened. Usually, these stories about how people become millionaires always start out with the people claiming they lived a poor life, they were so miserable, etc. But actually, with me, that's not how it started out. I wasn't rich, definitely not, but I was happy. My family and I could afford small holidays sometimes, and we didn't really need to be too concerned about getting food on the table and a roof over our heads. We weren't poor, but we weren't rich either. We were somewhere in the middle. But before I go on, be sure to hit that like and subscribe button, and smash that notification bell so you don't miss out on any of these awesome stories. If you do this in the next 5 seconds, you will become a millionaire when you're older. Trust me, it really works. When I was 16, my dad had us move to a new location for his job. He had gotten a promotion at his company, and even though I was really sad that I had to say goodbye to my friends, I was happy for him. He told me this new job was really exciting and he loved going to work. My first day at my new school was pretty hectic, to say the least. You see, I guess I was considered quite the handsome guy, or at least that's what lots of people told me. I didn't really know what they meant, to be completely honest, but I guess there's always the saying that people see you as 20% more attractive than you see yourself. Well, when I first got to school, I was surprised to find a lot of people wanted to be my friend. The new friends that I made told me a lot about how the girls thought I was cute and wanted to go out with me. I was pretty overwhelmed, but excited to know that I was popular. I was pretty much popular with everyone, that is, except for a peculiar guy called Michael. Michael was in the same class as me for pretty much every subject, and for some reason, he hated my guts. Whenever we were around, he would give me death stares and whisper insults under his breath. I'm pretty sure he was just jealous of me. One day, I was sitting at my lunch table when Michael appeared. He had a tray of food and pretended to trip over so that all his food landed on me. I easily saw through his act and stood up in anger. "What do you think you're doing?" I yelled. "Oh, sorry about that, Your Majesty," he said. Then he started laughing and walked away before I could say or do anything else. I was furious, and I wanted revenge. So my friends and I made a plan. We would sneak over to Michael's locker and fill it with something really embarrassing, so that when he opened it up, the whole school would see. We agreed on the plan and got all of it ready. Pretty soon, the next day, Michael walked over to his locker to get his books, while my friends and I waited around the corner. We were giggling and shoving each other because we were just so excited. Finally, Michael opened it up and out came a flood of stuffed animals. Michael stared in shock at all the teddy bears and bunny rabbits that spilled over his feet. And then he looked up at us in anger as he saw our red faces bursting with laughter. "Aw, is Michael a wee baby?" teased one of my friends. "Does Michael need a diaper?" I thought that was a little too harsh, but I couldn't stop laughing at Michael's face. He looked so mortified. The other students standing nearby started laughing too. Michael yelled out, "I'll get you back for this, Johnny." And then he stormed off with a look of pure hatred. We kept laughing until the bell rang for class. Then we headed off with tears of laughter streaming down our faces. In class, his last words echoed in my head. "I'll get you back for this, Johnny." But I wasn't too concerned. What was the worst he could do? Little did I know, Michael was capable of doing a lot. And if I had known what he would have done next, I would never have pranked him. I came home one day to find my father in the living room with my mother, who was crying. "What's going on?" I asked in a panic. "Johnny, there's something I have to tell you," said Dad. He motioned me to sit down next to him, and then he started to explain everything. "I've been fired from my job." "What?" I said in surprise. "But why?" "I have no idea, but don't you worry. We'll work things out." "But how will we live if you don't have a job?" My dad hesitated and looked at my mom. "I'm not exactly sure, but I'll make sure things are fine. I'll get a new job." But, Johnny, you know how the saying goes. What doesn't eat you makes you stronger. I nodded in agreement. He was right. We would make it through this. We could do it. But it was so shocking. Why would he be fired all of a sudden? Hadn't he just been promoted? Surely he hadn't done so bad a job that his bosses had to fire him. The next day at school, I was feeling blue. My dad had no job, we were worried about money, and I may have to move away again. I told my friends about it and they comforted me. But then I heard an evil laugh come from behind me. When I turned around, I saw it was Michael. "Your old man's been let off now, has he?" he sneered. "Shut up, Michael," I snapped. Michael laughed again. "I wonder why he got fired." "Michael, you can just stop," I started, but then I froze. I realized something was wrong. There was no way Michael could have overheard what I told my friends. I had whispered it to them, and yet, somehow, he had managed to overhear from 3 meters away. I turned to Michael and asked him if he had anything to do with my father's sudden sacking. "Maybe, maybe not," said Michael. I stood up suddenly. "Michael, please tell me you're joking." Michael laughed again. "My father may or may not be the owner of the company your father works at, and I may or may not have asked him to fire your dad." I felt my jaw drop. "Why would you do that?" Michael's smile disappeared, and he looked angry. "Because you're mean and you don't deserve all this popularity. You should just leave this school. I wish your father never got that transfer to a promotion. That way, I would never have met you." "Why do you hate me so much?" I asked. "What did I ever do to you?" Michael didn't say anything. He just turned on his heel and ran away. It was a good thing he ran away, too. I felt so angry, I could have punched him. On the way home from school, I contemplated whether or not I should tell my parents about what Michael had done. It would definitely help them a little to know that my dad hadn't been fired because he was bad at his job. But then they'd realize that it was all my fault. If I hadn't unconsciously made an enemy of Michael, then my dad would still have his job. I decided I would have to drop out of school or something. Get myself a job. I knew it was a desperate attempt, but I was gonna do it. On the bus ride home, I started planning out how I would get a job. I could work at a restaurant, or maybe a grocery store. The money would be little, but it would be something. But suddenly, I was pulled from my thoughts when I noticed a man in a business suit standing across from me. I was in a seat, and there were no other available seats on board. I stood up and tapped the man on the shoulder. "Here, take a seat," I said. The man smiled gratefully and sank into the chair, obviously exhausted. "Thanks, son." He paused and looked at me. "What's your name?" "Johnny." "Nice to meet you, Johnny. You can call me Ben." We didn't talk for a few minutes, but then I asked him what his job was. I thought I could maybe get a few ideas for my own future job. "I'm the host of a game show," he replied. I didn't expect that answer. "Wow, like a money game show or something?" "Yeah." Man, I wish I could go on one of those. My dad just got fired and I want to get a job to help out, but I know it's not gonna help out that much. I'm pretty stressed out. Ben smiled. "You know what? Why don't you come on my game show? You're a handsome lad. The viewers will love you." I couldn't believe my ears. "Wait, are you serious?" "Sure." The bus was slowing down and Ben stood up. "This is my stop, but here, call this number." He handed me his card. "And we'll work out a time and date." I couldn't believe my luck. "Thank you so much." "No worries." Ben smiled and walked off the bus. That evening, I told my parents about my meeting with Ben, and we immediately called him to figure out when would be a good time to shoot the game show. We worked out a date a week from now. I was so excited. I started studying material and general knowledge every night. My parents helped me too, and would test me a lot. I was a pretty smart kid already, so it wasn't too difficult a task. We found out that the highest prize on the game show was $1 million, but we weren't aiming for that because we knew it would be really difficult. Instead, we tried aiming for smaller prizes with the best chances of winning. Pretty soon, a week flew by, and it was time for my appearance on the game show. We drove over to the filming set, where I was prepped up in a suit and tie, and within a flash, I found myself on TV, live on air, seated across from Ben. "Ready?" asked Ben. I nodded. The first question was, "Which animal has 3 hearts? It was a multiple choice question with 4 possible answers. Llama, octopus, squid, monkey. "Octopus," I replied. The buzzer sounded, revealing I had answered correctly. And just like that, I got $5,000. The question seemed to fly by. And with each correct answer, I realized I was getting closer and closer to the $1 million cash prize. Before long, I found myself at the very last question. I was so stunned. How would I manage to answer them all correctly? I couldn't believe my luck. Ben smiled and gave me the final question. "For this one, you either have to answer yes or no. Do you understand?" I nodded. "Okay," said Ben. "Is Sydney the capital of Australia?" I hesitated. My immediate answer would have been yes, but then I wondered if this was too easy. It must be a trick question of some sort. And so, without really knowing whether this was right or wrong, I said, "No." Ben smiled again, and then golden lights shone from all the buzzers. I had won! I had won $1,000,000! I couldn't believe it! My parents ran on stage and we jumped for joy. We did it! We actually did it! For the rest of that week, we celebrated like kings and queens. I gave a lot of my money to family and friends, but saved up most of it. My friends were so happy for me, and I felt so good walking down the hallway, knowing that Michael knew I had become a millionaire. Revenge felt so sweet. I ended up telling Dad about Michael, and so he immediately went to his boss and demanded he reconsider. Turns out, his boss had fired him because Michael spread the lie that my dad was a cheater and was actually a past criminal. For a while, things were great. I loved being a millionaire. It certainly had its perks. But then, alas, like all good things, it came to an end. I was at home one day when I got a call from Ben. He told me I had to go to the filming set immediately. I was so confused, so I headed there with my dad. When we arrived, we saw the filming set had been prepared as if they were about to shoot another show. Ben was there, and that's when he explained everything, and my world came crashing down. He had said I had to answer the last question again because he had accidentally read the wrong answer from the card. That way, my win for $1,000,000 didn't actually count. I couldn't believe my ears. I could lose all my money. I thought I had no choice, so I agreed and sat on the seat. Ben pulled out a card and cleared his throat, then read the question. "This is a fill-in-the-blank answer. You understand?" I nodded. "All right," said Ben. "Fill in the blank for this popular saying. What doesn't blank you makes you stronger. What is the missing word?" I smiled. My dad told me this all the time. "Eat," I replied. Ben's face fell and he shook his head. "That's incorrect." I felt my stomach drop. I turned to Dad, who was seated in the empty audience chairs. "But you always told me what doesn't eat you makes you stronger." Dad scratched his head and looked confused. "I thought that was right." "The correct answer is what doesn't kill you makes you stronger," said Ben. "I'm sorry, Johnny, you lost all the money." I felt like I was gonna cry. I put my head in my hands, but then, all of a sudden, a loud alarm started to ring out, and Michael appeared from behind a curtain. "Ha, you just got pranked, Johnny," yelled Michael. "Of course that last question wasn't an accident. Get pranked," he teased. I was stunned beyond words. "So the money is still mine?" Ben smiled. "Of course, Johnny. Sorry about that. Michael hired me here for this prank. I really am sorry." Michael laughed at my shocked face. "And we got it all on footage," he said, pointing at the cameras. I was still speechless and glanced at my dad, who looked speechless too. I was glad the money was still mine. But man, Michael was a weird kid. Weird kid. Weird.